Special matrices in MATLAB are actually kind of fun. One of my favorite is the fact that you can, if you say want a 5 by 5 matrix of zeros, you can just say, hey, 0, 5 by 5 special matrices. And whoa, where'd you go? And it'll just do it, and it's amazing. And it's like, man, if I was in C, this would like actually, wait, I have to spell zeros right. This would actually take effort. And then you go, woo, look, I have a 5 by 5 matrix of zeros. I'm gonna CLC clear this to make it pretty like that. And look, there's a 5 by 5. I could make it a 3 by 5 matrix of zeros, and there you go. And it's all kinds of special. Actually, if I just wanted a 5 by 5 matrix of zeros, I could just say 5. And that would give me a 5 by 5. So if I just give it one number, it automatically gives me a square of that size. If I don't want it of that number, then it gives me just a regular size, whatever I tell it to give me. So that's kind of fun. So you can do zeros, you can do ones, it'll give you a 3 by 5 matrix of ones or a 5 by 5 matrix of ones, and you're like, yay! So it must be super easy. If I want twos, I just say a 3 by 5 matrix of twos, and then you're like, no, wait a second. That would be stupid, because then like MATLAB people would have to make a function specifically for threes and specifically for fours and specifically for fives, and you know, that's just kind of silly, so let's not do that. So, but still, no problem. If I want a 3 by 5 matrix of twos, I have a couple options. I could actually say, well, I'm going to say 2 times a 3 by 5 matrix of ones. Look at that, it's amazing. Or I can say I want 2 plus a 3 by 5 matrix of zeros, and it does it. So it's really not that complicated. So I could make a 3 by 5 matrix of 8.7s, you know? So make yourself a 3 by 5 matrix of 8.7s. Like, I know it's not hard because you just figured it out, but like pause it and be like, I'm gonna think on my own so I can learn stuff. And so make yourself a 3 by 5 matrix of 8.7s. Be like, okay. So I can do a 3 by 5 of ones, and I can multiply by 8.7. And, or I can say, I'm gonna make a 3 by 5 matrix of zeros and multiply it by, or add it to 8.7, and it's done, and yay! Really not that complicated. It's not that complicated until you get on a test and you're like, oh, I'm just gonna write 8.7s, 3 by 5. And so maybe that makes you realize why you couldn't just have a 2s and a 3s and a 4s and a 5s, because that would be really kind of silly. All right, so there's that. What else can we do? Zeros. Ooh, that was kind of fun. Let's do that. Have we done that yet? I think so. All right, let's do this one. So how could you create a random numbers? Instead of starting off between 10 and 75, let's do just 0 and 1. Let's do this one for later. Ah, come back. Oh, I just learned a new keyboard shortcut. 0 and 1. So maybe you remember this from a previous discussion. We want to make a 2 by 3 matrix of random numbers between 0 and 1. I'm just going to overwrite A. So think about it, see if you can remember how to do this, if you've seen this before. So basically I can come up with random 2 by 3, and that gives me numbers, random numbers between 0 and 1. I can do random 2 by 3. Now think about how this worked. See if you can remember, like pause the video and be like, I'm gonna learn how to do something independently because I wanna grow up and be useful and stuff. So if you remember, what you do is if you start out with a random 2 by 3, you look at the, thank you, you look at the size of this and you say, okay, well, to get from, so if you're having a hard time thinking 10 and 75, pull it down a little bit. We'll say I wanted to get something from, because anytime you don't know how to solve a problem, try to solve an easier problem and see what happens. So you say, what if I wanted to go between, you know, 3 and 5? Or not even 3 and 5. What about instead of 0 and 1, I say 0 and 3? You say, okay, well, I'm going to take what I had before, and I'm going to multiply it by 3. Because that would, thank you, not yet, not done yet. So if I multiply those random numbers by 3, not these specific random numbers, but if I multiply in general random numbers by 3, Instead of going from 0 to 1, I'll go from 0 to 3, so I scale it. I could say, all right, well, what if instead of going from 0 to 3, I wanted to go from, I don't know, 5 and 4 and 5? And you say, okay, well, I start with that original. The original one went from 0 to 1, but if I want to go from 4 to 5, then basically I'm going to shift my endpoints by 4. So 0 gets shifted to 4, 1 gets shifted to 5, and a shift is addition. So a scale is multiplication, and a shift is addition. So now I've shifted the numbers between 4 and 5. So if I wanted to create a 2 by 3 matrix of random numbers between, say, 2 and 5, I'm just making the numbers smaller so they're a little bit easier to see. You think, okay, well, I don't really have to change that, but I'm going to. You say, okay, well, I'm going to start with random numbers, and the size that I'm looking for in between 2 and 5 is 3, just like the size I was looking here is 3, like 3 to 0. 3 minus 0 is 3. So 5 minus 2 is 3, so it's still 3 wide, so I want to scale it by 3, but then the whole thing has been shifted, so I'm no longer starting at 2, I'm starting at 0, I'm now starting at 2, so I'm going to shift it by 2, and that'll get me random numbers between 2 and 5. Hopefully you've kind of seen some of this before. All right, so then if I want to create a 2 by 3 matrix of random numbers between 10 and 75, this is where you pause the video and you're like, I'm going to figure this out all on my own. It's going to be amazing. Doop-de-doo. So let's pretend you did that. And so I've got random numbers from 2 to 3. The size of this gap here is actually 65. So I'm going to scale it by 65. And then I want to shift it to the bottom number, plus 10. And there are my random numbers between 10 and 75. Kind of fun. What else can we do? So now here are some other special matrices in MATLAB that you should practice with. See if you can be comfortable with them. Make sure you understand what they do. We kind of went over the first couple, but you should play with the rest of them. We'll pretend that you did that. Remember, if you're just watching the videos and not actually participating, you're not like learning stuff. You're not actually learning anything, so you really do want to do this. So we already did these first. So let's explore what this one does. So you're like, I don't know what this does, so I'm just going to make a random matrix. Except I can't type random numbers very well because typing is hard. So there I have A. I'm going to CLC clear this to start. Okay, so I have this matrix. Best way to figure out what it does, see what it does. And that's not that surprising. You might think, well, diag, that sounds like diagonal. And you're like, yay, I'm somewhat competent at reading. Yay. So diag just literally just pulls the diagonals off the stupid matrix. 3, 2, 9. 3, 2, 9. Yay. Okay. I'm trying to be more excited about it. I was more excited about it than maybe it warrants, but that's all right. Let's see. Let's try flipr. Doesn't take too much effort to realize what's going on here. If I show you A, and then I do fliplr, except now you can't see. Let me move blah out of the way. Blah, you need to go away. All right, so if I have A, and then I have fliplr A, kind of see what that does? See how it flips it from left to right? So I have 338. And now my 338's over here. And then I have 299, but now my 299's over there. And 620's still in the middle, because, you know, when you flip something, and you have an odd number of things, the thing in the middle stays the same. Flipud, not too much of an effort. Let me suppress this guy now. See what that guy does? Yeah, it flips it up and down. Maybe that's what U and D stand for. Amazing. Okay, that was exciting. Now magic. Magic, so I can't spell. If I try to do magic A, oh, that's interesting. I wasn't sure what I was going to get out of that. That's not what I want to do, though. I was just doing that. I thought it was going to give me an error, but it didn't. I'll say magic 3. It's going to give me the same thing, but that's all right. All right. So if you look at magic 3, you might be like, I don't know what that is. So
And you read that and you go, huh? So you got your magic square and you look and you go, okay, that's the same number I got. It's called the magic square because the sum of the elements in each column is the same. 8, 3, and 4 is 15. 1, 5, and 9 is 15. 6, 7, and 2 is 18. You're like, oh. And the sum of the elements in each row is the same. The diagonal elements have the same sum as well. So if I look at this, I can actually see that 8, 3, and 4 add up to 15. 1, 5, and 9 are 15. 6, 7, and 2 is 15. 4, 9, and 2 is 15. 3, 5, and 7 is 15. 8, 1, and 6 is 15. And 6, 5, and 4 is 15. And 2, 5, and 8 is 15. You're like, this is amazing. So basically, if I just, I don't really know why this is irrelevant, it's just kind of fun to play with. There's a 7 by 7 magic square, and all of the, if I sum the, whatever you call it, if I sum, here, let me go, I'll type it up here. Let's make this a magic 7. If I sum the whatever, that'll give me the sum of each column. If I sum the whatever thingied transposed, that will give me the sum of the columns, it looks, or the sum of the rows. I can sum the diagonals of whatever. 175, kind of cool. All right, that's kind of neat. Anyway, so those are just some kind of fun matrices that you can play around with and see what they do, because who knows when you're going to accidentally need a magic matrix? No, not really. But this flip up and down, the flip left and right, and the diagonal, those are definitely useful little functions to have at your disposal.